Hey guys, welcome to Laratips. In today's video, we'll be looking into a package named as Laravel Blanket. It provides us a very nice dashboard to view our HTTP client requests in Laravel application. And if you don't know about HTTP client in Laravel, then I have created a very detailed video about this from basic to advanced. You can watch this video tutorial. And there is also another this Laravel's hidden trait forward calls, and here also I have used the HTTP client and used multiple APIs, and I have shown you how to use the Laravel HTTP client to handle those. I'll be leaving the link of both of these tutorials just below that like button. You can have a look at both of those. Now let us go back to this Laravel blanket package. And here you can also see this screenshots where it shows the HTTP request. And now let me install this package and show you guys here. Okay, so let me go here how to install. And also it requires PHP version 8.0 and greater and Laravel version 8 and greater. So here I'll just copy this. And I'll come here in my project Laratips and paste it over here. Composer required. The package is successfully installed, and also we need to publish the assets. Just copy this, come here in the terminal and paste. The blanket scaffolding also installed successfully. Okay, after this we need to also publish the migrations because it has one migration file. So here I'll just publish the migration files and just copy this PHP artisan migrate and run. Okay, we have some issues over here. Base table or view already exists, and it is showing this error because before starting this tutorial I have already migrated, so you will not get this error. And I have already here this table, you can see here blanket logs table over here, so it was showing that issue. Okay, so let me just clear this log, and now we can see here, so we'll have this config blanket.php. so here if I just show you here what are the files that have been changed over here, these are the things that have been added. So this is the blanket config file over here, which is inside this config folder here, and we can enable or disable this by using this blanket underscore enabled. Just go here in the .env file, and let's say you don't want to enable this blanket for some reason, then you can just say false like this and it will not log any changes. So for now I'll just leave it as it is, so it will be true. And here also it is saying hide sensitive data, which means that if we pass any headers, here we have this authorization header, it will never log this authorization header as well as these headers. And also in the request, it will not log this password and password confirmation as well. And also we have this blanket path. So I am here in my Laratips dot test. Okay, this is the domain. Now I'll just say here blanket like this, and it will take me to this dashboard as you can see here. And you can change this URL, you can write anything that you want. And also we have this middleware. Currently it is only applying web middleware to it, but let's say we don't want this to be accessible publicly, we want some kind of authorization to it, then also we can add that middleware. Let's say we only want super admin to access it, then we can just create a middleware and add it over here, and then it will just work like charm. And also we have here this blanket response limit, which is 64 KB by default, and this is the max limit, and if you want to just decrease it, then just add a value over here. Similarly, how many logs we want to see in the page, so it is showing me 100, so I'll just add here let's say 20. Okay, in one page, so here in one page we only want to see the 20 logs. And it is saying here prune logs duration, which means that after how long you want to prune the database records. And it is saying here now sub month, which means that any records past 1 month will be automatically deleted. And if you don't know about prune in the Laravel, then you can also watch my video tutorial. I have also created a video about that. We have seen the configuration file, but here in the dashboard we are not seeing anything because we haven't submitted any HTTP request. And it is not the HTTP normal request, but HTTP client request, whatever the request that we send from the facade. So now let me go here in this JSON placeholder website. In this website we have some free resources or some free APIs that we can use. So now let me just use these APIs using the HTTP facade. I'll just go to here in the Tinkerwell and I'll paste some code over here. HTTP get this HTTP JSON placeholder and /post/1, which means it will give me the post with the ID of 1. So here I am just executing it, and we can see here the user with the ID of 1. post with the ID of 1. I have just submitted a GET request. And if I come here in the browser and just see here in this dashboard, just reload here, then we can see here this post request, because I submitted that request twice. So it is showing me these two records. Okay. And by default, it will just show it like this. And one great thing about this package is it has also this dark mode. So here, this is the request that I have sent, and just I'll click here. Then we can see here what are the headers that were sent and the payload. And if you see here, no payload is sent over here, so it is not showing anything. And in the response also, it is showing all the response headers. And at the bottom, we have body. Whatever we have got from this is over here. Similarly, I have some post, put and delete requests. I'll just add them over here and I'll show you. Now let me just write here this post request. I'll just comment it out. So this is the post request. It will create a post. So I'll just run it and let me comment it out and let me add another put request. So here is the put request and I'll just run it. And you can see here this foo is updated. Okay. And similarly, let me add one delete request for you. And let me run it one more time. Then we can see here empty, which means it is deleted. And now if I come here in the browser, let me just minimize it, and or you can reload the page or just click here, then it will show you all the HTTP requests that is sent over here. And if you only want to see the GET request, then just click here, then it will just filter by the GET request or POST request. Or if you want to see all, then you can see here. And also it will show here the domain name. So currently the domain or the base domain is this JSON placeholder dot this URL. And it is showing me over here. But suppose let's say we have multiple domains, or we have sent requests to the multiple domains, then also we'll be able to see it over here. Let me just show you that. So here I'll just comment this out and I'll submit a request to a different domain, which is my own this laratips.test domain. And here I have this laratips API, and I can send any method on this get request, post request that is available in this HTTP facade. It is using HTTP facade internally. And if you want to know how to create such kind of class which automatically inherits all the methods of this HTTP facade, then you can watch a tutorial in my channel. I have already created a video about that. The link of that video will be in the description box. Now let me just send get request to the users API. Then we can see here a list of all the users. And now if I come here and refresh the page, we can see here this API/users. And here also, if I just go here inside the responses, then we can see here a list of all the users. And now here in the source base URL, we can see here laratips.test. Now we can only see the list of the laratips.test. And now again, if I just refresh the page, then I can see all the data. And again, let's say I only want to see the request of JSON placeholder, then just click here and you can see those over here. In Laravel, by default, we don't have a way of looking what are the HTTP requests that has been sent using the HTTP facade. And this package makes it very easy for us to view the HTTP records in a beautiful UI with both light and dark theme. I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Bye.